finally, after over a year of accumulating all the necessary parts, my solar power battery backup system is getting installed. The installers have been at it for a few hours. They are on a lunch break right now, but they're getting the mounting rails ready to put the solar panels up on the roof.
Up on the roof.
And they have the beginnings of like the wall of awesomeness where the power is gonna be managed. We'll talk more about this later when it gets there. I was originally planning on having the batteries out here as well, but the shop isn't insulated. There's no climate control. On days when it gets below freezing in there, the batteries just won't work anymore. So I have the batteries in my dining area right now. I ordered a cart from Amazon for them. It'll sit right here. The table will slide back over there and they'll be tucked underneath the table. And the power inverter is right on the other side of this wall, so they're gonna just wire the batteries through the wall. These are 48 volt, 100 amp hour lithium iron batteries.
Addie?
Yes, Daniel.
Go ahead and let the viewers know about the different types of batteries I was deciding between.
Right away, sir. Lead acid batteries were a long time standard for affordable energy storage. They have a short lifespan, off gas, and require regular maintenance. AGM batteries are a step up from lead acid. They last longer, don't off-gas, and are maintenance-free. Lithium-ion batteries has the benefits of AGM batteries, but last longer, and have a deeper depth of charge. Sadly, they also are the most expensive.
She's good, isn't she?
It has been a few days. I'm going to show you the update on the solar installation, but first, we're going to check in with Dan's partner and see how her chickens and chicken tractor are doing.
So it's been a week with chickens. How's it been going?
It's been good. I love my chickens. The chicken tractor broke the day after we built it.
When I picked it up to move it, this whole entire seam here split and this section of the wood came out. We put a metal bracket here to reinforce it, but every time we move it, it feels like it's gonna rip apart, so we have just left it where it's at.
I emailed the company a couple days ago to let them know. They apologized, but I told them, you know, we're not gonna be part of their marketing campaign anymore because we can't endorse it. I came up with a plan to help reinforce it. So I have this old 1x4 lumber laying around my property. So we're gonna bolt this on the inside of the tractor. It's gonna be on the inside of this lip so the doors can still function and open out. But having the solid piece of wood that goes all the way across in there is gonna help strengthen this up. All right, give it a test move, see how it feels.
Feels better.
You think it's gonna break?
Not right away.
Okay, but it's better.
Much better.
Up on the roof.
Up on the roof.
We have our solar panels installed. I think they're either 240 or 250 watts. With the four panels, that makes 1,000 watts. All right, here is the system. Boom. It's kind of hot, so this fan is running on here right now. Okay, it stopped. We can talk now. So obviously the solar panels collect the solar energy from the roof. Comes down a wire here to this box. It's kind of like a circuit breaker for the solar panels. I can flip them on and off right there. These boxes here, I have one here, here, and here. Those are basically surge protectors. Really good ones. So leaving this box, it goes over here to the charge controller, and this is telling me what we're getting right now. We have 87.9 volts coming in, 0.4 kilowatt hours. From the charge controller, it goes over to the inverter. This takes it from DC power to AC power. This is where it gets kind of cool. So if there's no electricity, the power goes out, I can turn the inverter on like that. I'm gonna turn it back off though. Uh-oh. Okay, it's off. Then I'm gonna flip this down, flip that up, which is gonna make the electricity go out here, and it routes all the way back there to my electric panel. And from back here, I would flip this switch off, which shuts me off from the grid, flip that. That will cause the electricity coming from the power inverter to actually supply power to this panel. That works the same way if you have a generator and one of these things where you can plug the generator into to supply power to your house through the panel. Same thing's happening here, except it's solar. During the less sunny season, if I did lose electricity and wanted to power the house and charge the batteries at the same time for the solar system, I can just plug in the generator and it'll charge the batteries and power the house. And I forgot to mention the batteries, they're right down here beneath the inverter. So it's actually going from the charge controller to the inverter, being stored down in the batteries. Like I said earlier, the batteries are gonna be stored inside the house to keep them warm during the winter. I ordered the cart we're gonna store them on from Amazon and it's arrived, but the technician who's supposed to come back and do the install for it, he's supposed to run these wires through the wall, through a receptacle. He hasn't come back, so I don't know when that's happening. But because it's 90 degrees out, I'm not worried about leaving the batteries in there for now. They're fine for right now. It's just when we get to this winter. That is my fully functioning solar backup power system. So my 2021 goal of getting some energy resilience, check. Little buddy asked if we could turn the power off to the house on the panel and run off of solar for a little while and just check it out, see how it goes. I told him that's a great idea. I'd love to do that, but like I said, it's 90 degrees out. I'm running AC right now. That's not gonna work on the battery system. And I'm not particularly interested in getting hot just to experiment right now. Those batteries are designed to keep those freezers running if the power goes out. And I can run some lights, charge a cell phone, that kind of thing. It's not designed to run AC. Our summers in Idaho are fairly short, so it won't take long for us to get cool enough weather to give this a spin.